Hello everyone, in this video we'll discuss numericals based on Horton's infiltration equation. So the question is, infiltration capacity of a soil is following this model or this equation. Now during an experiment it was found that initial infiltration capacity of a soil was 200 millimeters per hour, and after a long time it reduced to 25 millimeters per hour. The question is, what is the value of decay constant if the infiltration capacity after 1 hour is given? So if you look at this equation, you will find that this equation is analogous to Horton's infiltration equation, which is F is equals to Fc plus F0 minus Fc e to the power minus kt. This is by Horton's, where F is the infiltration rate at any time, Fc is the constant rate which has been achieved after a long time, F0 is the initial rate which is at the beginning of the rainfall when the moisture content is low and a lot of evaporation will take place because the pores are empty. So to fill that, it will happen at a faster rate. So in this question, we have C1 plus C2 e to the power minus kt. If you compare these two equations, you will see that C1 is equals to Fc and C2 is equals to F0 minus Fc. From the question, it is clear that initially, this is infiltration rate versus time. So initially it is given the value is 200. So that is our F0. So F0 value is 200 millimeters per hour. Now after a long time, it has reduced to say some value which is 25. Question is, at t is equals to 1 hour or at the end of 1 hour, the infiltration value is how much? 90 mm per hour. This is in mm per hour and this is the time. So you know, at any given instant we can apply Horton's equation. So substituting all the values, that is at F is equals to 1 hour, it is 90. Substituting all the values of F0, Fc, in this equation, we will get F is equals to, what is the value of Fc? 25 plus F0 minus Fc will be 200 minus 25 e to the power minus k, which we have to find t. This is the infiltration equation at any given time t. Now we know from the boundary condition that at t is equal to 1, F is equals to 90. Now solving it, when we solve this, it will come out as 0.3715. Now what you can do is take log on both the sides. So here we'll take log of base E, that is ln. So when we take log on both the sides, we'll get this value as minus 0.99. So k value will be 0.99, unit will be hour inverse. So this is the decay coefficient that we found. So this is one type of numerical. Now another type of numerical that we can have is, now another type of question that we can have is this. So infiltration capacity in a basin is represented by this equation. So for a basin, after doing certain tests by using infiltrometer, we got the data which we fit on a Horton's equation. So the equation that we get is this. Now in this equation, Fp is nothing but the infiltration rate at any point of time t is this. The units are in centimeters per hour. Time is in hours. So now, if the storm or the rainfall event lasts for 1 hour, that is for 60 minutes, the question is asking what is the depth of infiltration in the first 30 minutes of the storm. So we have something like this. This is our Horton's infiltration curve. In this question, it is given that this is our F naught, this is FC. So, if the storm lasted for 1 hour, in the first 0.5 hours or in the first 30 minutes, what will be the depth of infiltration? So, we have to find the area under this curve. So, area under this curve can be found by integrating this equation. So, the limits for integration will be, we have to find for first 30 minutes, convert it into hours because the time that we have to put is in hours. So, for first 30 minutes, 30 minutes when we convert into hours, that is 30 by 60, it will come out to be 1 by 2, that is 0.5. Infiltration equation at any point of time will be 3 plus e to the power minus 2t dt. Now simply you have to integrate this equation. So we'll just separate. Now simple 3 dt integration will be 3t, put the limits. Similarly, e to the power minus 80, integration of e to the power minus 80 will be e to the power minus 80 divided by minus a. Put the limits from t to 0. Similarly, here we will do e to the power minus 2t minus 2.5 to 0. Now simply you have to put the upper limits. So here the answer that you will get will be 1.816 centimeters. Now this is when the question has asked for first 30 minutes. If the question is asking for next 30 minutes, the limits will be from 0.5 to 1. If the question asks what is the infiltration during the entire storm, that is for entire 60 minutes the question is asking. So the limits will be from 0 to 1. Entire storm lasted for 1 hour. So that is this case. So, you have seen these two numericals. In the next videos, we will solve another type of numerical based on Horton's equation. This equation is used to find out the infiltration rate or to find out the total infiltration due to any given storm. So, whenever we need to find out the losses from precipitation to evaluate the runoff, infiltration can be found by using Horton's equation. Simply integrate the equation within the time interval for which you are studying. And then you can find out the infiltration depth.